in high definition. This is KCAL 9 News at Noon.
Big weekend coming up here for Habitat for Humanity. They're going to be building 10 homes at a neighborhood playground right here in the Southland. Popular actress will join us to tell us about that program.
Also, jury select. And it's going to be a really big weekend for Habitat for Humanity volunteers building several homes, also a playground, all right here in the Southland. We have details on how you can help. It's all coming up next. Right, you have a wonderful opportunity to help pay it forward this coming weekend.
Local volunteers are rolling up their sleeves and powering up their tools to help build some homes and a playground. We'll show you how you can get involved.
You're watching KCAL 9 News at Noon.
Women?
Yes?
Put on your tool belts and arm yourself with some power tools. Get ready to build some homes for Habitat for Humanity.
Boy, this is exciting. This weekend, hundreds of women, including some Hollywood celebrities, are going to help build several houses and a playground. It's all happening in Sylmar. It's part of the second annual Women Empowerment Build, We Build. Right now, we welcome actress Takiyah Crystal Kima and Habitat for Humanity's Michael Mizrahi. Welcome to both of you. Boy, this sounds exciting.
Thank you.
And I love the pink hard hat. Yeah,
I was going to wear it, but, you know, I didn't want to.
Come on, put it on.
Why not? There it is. This is how it really looks.
So is this just for women?
It is in celebration of women, but empowered men are welcome, sir. I just want to let everybody know that.
Do I have to wear a pink helmet, though, if I show up?
You can be cool and take it off.
If I have to wear one, so do you.
I guess those ball players, because we used pink bats yesterday. It's okay. Tell me about the history of Habitat for Humanity before we get into this specifically. It goes back quite a ways.
Oh, yes, it does. This affiliate that we're representing right now serves the San Fernando and the Santa Clarita Valleys. But Habitat, we were just talking about, is really kind of a slice of Americana, isn't it? Yes. When you think about communities coming together, raising a barn, raising a home for other people. And that's really the mission here. The mission here is to raise up people who are caught in the cycle of poverty housing and to develop neighborhoods that way. So it's very exciting what we're doing.
And this event specifically will help people right here in our own neighborhood, right here in the Southland.
Yeah, and I just wanted to jump on that ever since I saw Jimmy Carter talking about Habitat for Humanity many, many years ago, I thought, oh, I want to do that. And I know a lot of people feel like that. Well, that's something I'm going to do one day. Let this be the day to do it, because I did it for the first time. In fact, this chapter had the women's build for the first time last year, and I participated. It was so much fun that I have taken complete credit for the house. I think I put 25 nails in, as if there was no one else there. And when we did the walk this fall, I met the family who lives there now. And it's just...
And you told them, hey, that's
you know, I live. But yeah.
You're getting tired of you driving by?
Not yet. No, it's so much fun, and it's so well organized. They make sure that you don't have to have any experience at all. They'll find something for you to do. We had contests. I won this which I won this measuring. I never use it, but I won it in the contest that we had last year. They make sure that it's not only an empowering day, and it's extraordinary to see hundreds and hundreds of women. We have, you know, actresses, directors, writers, producers, doctors, lawyers, scientists. We had a rocket scientist speak last year. It's like, okay, what is your job? Never mind. But we're coming together, and men too. We have actually a lot of men and a lot of companies, utility companies that come and provide expertise. It's a wonderful experience, and you can also raise money. Last year, the construction, the donation of bodies, of labor, saved them $100,000.
Wow.
In addition, they raised $50,000 in cash from the build. And so it's an incredible thing. This structure where we are is called an enriched neighborhood, and this build this weekend finishes the last 10 houses in that neighborhood.
Oh, that's exciting.
It's just
wonderful.
Can we
jump on that real quick? The enriched neighborhood idea is really unique to this affiliate. In addition to the house that we're providing for these folks, we bring in an array of services, educational and social services, as well as training that Habitat provides. Things like English as a second language, computer skills, money management skills.
Homework tutors.
Tutors for adolescents. And this helps to enable further success as they move on down. Can I give you a website for details
yes.
on the We Build? I want to make sure everybody
gets
this.
Yes, I meant to say that.
So that would be go to humanityca.org, humanityca.org, and you can get the full rundown of details on this.
All right.
And just on this neighborhood program in Pacoima, there's the ratio of high school graduates is just abominably low.
Yeah.
In the enriched neighborhoods, it's 93% go on to college.
Wow.
100% graduate from high school, 93% graduate from college or trade school after they graduate
Very
from high
impressive.
School. So incredibly, incredibly important program. We need your help.
Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. They're doing so much more than just building houses. The second annual Women Empowerment Build event is this Saturday and Sunday. No special skills needed. You do have to be 16 years old to participate. Registration $40, $25 for any students who want to join the fun. For more information, just go to kcal9.com. We've got all the information right there. You just click Seen on TV. Michael
good,
and Takiya,
good luck this
thanks.
Weekend.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks
Thank
for
you.
Having us.
It looked like a lot of fun. It was a drizzly start.